Listed firm Frutas Holdings saw a strong first half with revenue and net income soaring more than 40%. It hopes to continue that momentum as it seeks to add more brands to its portfolio. Just recently, it acquired the kitchen equipment of Food Panda.
Joining us now in the studio to talk more about the company's expansion plans and the local F&B scene, we have Calvin Chua, Director and Chief Financial Advisor of Frutas. Calvin, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having us, Salve and Ron.
Hi, Calvin.
Gosh, you have had a very fruitful year.
Yes. It's been very fruitful.
I love making him laugh. Sometimes when we talk to other people here, our guests say, you know, it's a difficult year. The equity sector, of course, has been having a really hard time. But your numbers, there's no confusion.
Right.
First quarter and second quarter, all up 48% higher.
There's no confusion because I think consumers are really coming back, really consuming our products. They see the value in our products. And I think with more innovation and more brands, we should continue momentum in the second half.
I was going to ask the same question. I was going to ask him what the secret sauce was for that strategy.
It's fruit.
I can't find a good pun I could use like food.
I always argue you on puns.
I was going to ask what the strategy was, but because of the numbers that you have, but let me maybe ask what lessons you learned in the previous years, most especially during the pandemic, that you had adjusted to perform this well.
Yeah, I think just before the pandemic, we were quite reliant on malls, right?
Mm.
And obviously when malls closed down, our numbers fell down in the same manner. I think at one point we were only operating, 10, 20 stores? And it took us a while to go back, but quickly pivoted. We actually opened community stores, I think, in a span of 12 months or 15 months, we were able to open 100 community stores.
Wow.
So which opened up another distribution channel for our products. And also, we were able to curate other third-party products, adding revenue streams for us.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm. And what else? I think what we've seen is you just need to continue to evolve as a company. We were primarily a kiosk-based business, but last year we actually acquired Lingnam, which was casual dining, and we've built our cloud kitchen business.
Do they still have that Lingnam store in Green Hills? Do you remember?
No, not anymore, but I'm thinking of a different restaurant.
Yeah.
You will see us more in the second half. We're actually opening, I think, two in Makati. We're actually opening one in Zamboanga very soon. So you'll see us a lot of Lingnam stores in the next few months.
What's that game where the fruits eat each other? It looks like there's a game like that. Wait, so for this strategy to work, you need to have a lot of cash. Even during COVID, you open up 100 community stores. I don't even know what those look like. But even then, that meant you had to have cash to deploy.
Correct.
And now you're continuing to buy and eat up so many more fruits.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
That's two, Ron. Right? And so what's the, okay to ask how much cash Frutas has?
Yeah, I think we have about 600 million in cash now. We have a lot of support from relationship banks.
Mm.
Yeah, I won't go through the details of how much lines we have, but
in a buying spree.
We have a lot of support from relationship banks, starting from the top banks to the mid-sized banks.
And you had the investment from Tomanitan late last year.
Yes, we did.
120 million.
It was a secondary shares, but yes, we're proud to be, entertaining new investors into our fold. One of the other new investors was the former owner of Fly Kitchen. So when we bought Fly Kitchen, the cloud kitchen business of Christopher Young, he actually invested some of the shares, some of the money back into our company.
Okay.
So very proud of that because people are beginning to see the strides that we've been making. And yeah, when we're making these acquisitions, we're actually always looking at, you know, a 12-month horizon and a 3-year horizon, a 5-year horizon, right? So when we bought, for example, Fly Kitchen, it was with the intention of, you know, how would we then improve our relationship with the food aggregators, and that was one of the recent deals that we announced, which was to buy some equipment and technology from Food Panda, that will then open us up to partnerships with other international brands. So hopefully we will be able to, tall manufacture for some brands in the next few months, and would be happy to announce them here.
Wow! Please,
so we'll have you over again.
We'll bump off other guests.
Thank you.
But with getting Fly Kitchen and getting the equipment of Food Panda, how is that going to strengthen your existing brands? Is it going to be, are they going to be affected as well?
Okay. We actually acquired 4 kitchens from Fly Kitchen. We have 2 kitchens from our new Bicocina business. I think in the next few months, that should grow to about 10 kitchens. Obviously, what you hear in the food in F&B industry is a digital type of strategy.
Everybody's
right?
So, doing puns.
Correct. So it has to be a combination. We've seen and we acknowledge that there's been really a change in how people order, how people consume, right? Mm-hmm. And if you just look at other countries, like for example, China, digital orders for, let's say, Yum China is up to 90%, right? So there's really no turning back in that evolution. And we just need to change. And if you don't change, you
die.
Yeah.
But physical will not disappear. It's still physical.
Physical
digital.
Will not disappear, and it's really managing and putting yourselves in strategic locations. Mm-hmm. For example, we actually launched a yogurt brand. Mm-hmm. We didn't necessarily quickly launch. We didn't reach 100 stores for that yogurt brand, because we actually leveraged off our existing brands, other existing brands, our community stores, and put in some, you know, hubs where people can just order.
I noticed that the soy and bean, the even the balay, they're all together in one space.
Yes. Yeah. And that's, I think, one of our strengths. We want to be there during the morning, during lunch, during the afternoon, and even evening.
So. Maybe you're there more than the spouses.
hopefully. We have this vision of having each Filipino household consume one of our Frutas brands, out every day or every week at least, right? So. Okay. We're still a long way, but we're getting there. We're getting there.
Now, your shopping list. So you have 600 million. What's the thinking behind the things that you're going to buy next? Are there some big names right there that may be happening before the year ends or in 2024? Yeah. And then beyond that, how do you choose?
Yeah. So a lot of it is looking at their supply chain. Easy wins, right? So our supply chain involves fruits, right? So are there other peripheral businesses that can lever off that? We are also looking at value-added acquisitions, right? So we started with balay, which was really a lot of pandesal, tasty loaves, etc. But do we then move to the next stage of really getting into cakes, for example, which would have higher margins? We've had a good experience with Lingnam, so casual dining is definitely in our target. And of course, just increasing our presence online is there. So there are different pillars in our strategy. So one is strengthening our core brands. Mm-hmm. Core brands being Frutas, Jamaican, and Buko. It's expanding our e-commerce business. So that's a second pillar. The third pillar is really our community stores and the Balay business. So, you know, anything beyond that will be maybe one off. We'll have to discuss it, you know, more thoroughly in the board.
No hints on the next big
Not yet.
Come on.
There will be more, but not yet.
Okay, when we bump off the next back.
Okay, let's talk about how Frutas is still expanding, carrying over this momentum outside of Metro Manila, outside of the country. And I do want to ask about the franchises. How much of it is contributing to the mother company?
Currently, and actually ever since, we've not been a franchise-heavy business. Mm-hmm. The thinking behind that is we really wanted to be on the ground ourselves. Mm-hmm. We wanted our own people to have a feel of how people consume, right? But lately, we've been increasing. I think currently it's about 15% for stores or franchise. It may go up to 20-25%. Of course, there's advantages, right? It's asset light. You get to maximize your commissary capacity. But yeah, it has to be managed. Some of our Lingnam stores upcoming would be franchises. So I guess it's really a matter of capital management. We see a lot of benefit also partnering with people who have knowledge of their own market. Mm-hmm. So Zamboanga, for example, of course we have Frutas stores there, but there are people who have a lot more knowledge of the Zamboanga market.
Yeah. And what's the thing they eat there in Zamboanga with a lot of fruit, the parang ice cream with? Are you gonna go into that too?
I don't know yet.
I forgot the name, what it's called. It's really good.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, okay, so I was thinking about your numbers. Let me just step back a little and go back into that. It's obvious that it's the expenses are not growing. Also, you're keeping the expenses light because your net income is at 48%. Your revenues are growing 45%. Gross profit is almost there also.
It went down maybe a percentage point or two, obviously because of inflation. Mm-hmm. But we're trying to manage it by increasing productivity, increasing efficiency. There's going to be a lot more automation at the back end. Leveraging off this different locations, right? Not necessarily just adding more stores, but making sure that they are profitable.
Mm-hmm. And capital is not hard to come by now.
Capital is, if you look at interest rates of banks, they're going higher. Mm-hmm. But fortunately, we had IPOs before the pandemic, and just before the interest rates really went up, and inflation rates went up. So we're
cash rich.
Cash rich at the moment.
This is great news. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks, Calvin.